stubble must be buried on the street. Walking on the block, this is a Mr. Rule.
Fred!
Oh, is it time?
Dude, get with the program.
Okay, sorry, it's time. Good evening, friends, and welcome again to Fridays with Fab Freddie. You've come to the right place. You know why you're here. It's Friday happy hour, and we'll celebrate once again with a couple of cocktails. Actually, it's two for one again this Friday. We'll have two cocktails for the price of one, and we're so happy you could join us. We'll talk about the cocktails in just a moment. So thank you, our Biloxi Little Theatre friends, for joining us. We're always happy to have you. A couple of notes about Biloxi Little Theatre. We're hoping, now that things are opening up more, we're looking at possibility of toward the end of July to open for a weekend. And of course we're considering all the options and considering all the safety protocols that we will need to put in place if we can do that. Hopefully we can do that. And definitely, hopefully by September, we will be able to open our 75th season milestone at Biloxi Little Theatre with our musical, Your Good Man Charlie Brown. Auditions, there are auditions for Your Good Man Charlie Brown coming up. It's an adult cast, Friday and Saturday, June 12th and 13th. If you go to the Biloxi Little Theatre Facebook page and then under events, you can find out all the information you need about auditions for Your Good Man Charlie Brown. Also want to welcome our happy hour friends. Great to have you with us again. You've been loyal for many of you for years, so thank you. We had last week's show, we had almost 2,000 views. So all of you out there, thousands of you that I don't know, we're happy you could be with us. Thank you for joining us. And if you don't know me, I'm Fred Thomas. I'm the Biloxi Little Theatre administrator, house manager, all of that stuff. Okay, now that we've gotten the news out of the way, you know what I have to ask you next is to silence your communicators. Let's see. I think we may be getting another message from the captain. It's not coming in. Low frequency, captain. Anyway, phasers on stun. Okay. Next question, and you know this is coming. Am I wearing pants? We'll let you know later on toward the end of the show. You're welcome to guess if you want to as we go along. Okay, let's get started with our cocktails. Both of them will have a similar ingredient, half and half, and they will both be kind of creamy, desserty, both delicious, but very different. Let's start with our first one, and staying with our Broadway show title names for cocktails, our first one is called Merrily We Roll Along. And you'll see why we call it that, because it's going to be a lot of fun, and we'll just enjoy the drink as we go. So,
Fred, you've got all kinds of friends on here tonight.
Who do we have?
We got Judy Madden.
Judy, happy birthday to you, Judy.
Charlene Deaton.
Charlene, thank you.
Joelle,
good to have you again.
LaWanda,
welcome back.
Hillary,
thank you.
Ooh, Brandon's here.
Brandon.
Shelly,
thank you, Shelly.
Carolyn,
all of you.
Your number one fan, Nicole.
and of course, Nicole, my president of the Fab Freddie fan club. Okay, let's get started with our Merrily We Roll Along. We will start with some almond liqueur. It's almond flavored liqueur. This is a good one. You don't, as I've talked about before, you don't have to go for the high-end, expensive brands. Amaretto di Serrano, of course, is wonderful, but you don't have to pay that extra money for that. Wait until you're enjoying that on its own, sipping it as a cordial or on the rocks. This is a perfectly good imported Italian amaretto that we will use. So let's go. Let's start with 2 ounces. 2 ounces of our almond liqueur. And next, we'll add an Irish cream liqueur. Bailey's, of course, is the first brand that everyone thinks of when you mention Irish cream. It is expensive, and it's widely known because of marketing, and it is very good. It's delicious. However, there are other brands that are less expensive that are just as good. This is a good one. Ryan's, Carillon's is another one that's a little less expensive. That's also very good. So again, you know, save your money for the high-end, top-shelf brands when you're drinking them, maybe in a purer form, just on their own or on the rocks, something like that. Okay, so that's our almond liqueur, our Irish cream liqueur, and now we will add some whipped vodka. This will give it a little whipped cream, top-it-off taste. Let's do another 2 ounces of our whipped vodka. This will also give it that extra kick that you know my cocktails are known for. So whipped cream vodka. And then we'll finish with half and half. I'm using fat-free half and half. You can use regular half and half. You can use regular milk. If you don't want to do dairy at all, you can use soy milk or almond milk. So any of those will work. They won't be quite as rich and creamy as the half and half, but they will work just as well. So let's do 4 ounces of our half and half, 4 or 5 ounces. And there we have the ingredients for our Merrily We Roll Along. Stir, not shake. Let's put some ice in our glass and we're ready to have this delicious desserty drink that I know you will enjoy. That's little Roo, that's Roo Kitty. You hear howling in there. She will be 18 years old next month, and she likes to let everybody know that. All right, here we go.
Cindy is here and says this is Pants Watch 2020.
Thank you, Cindy. There's our Merrily We Roll Along. Let's dress it up. Add some monkeys in the front, of course. And we're ready. Oh, Root Kitty's coming to visit. Hey, Root Kitty. You want more treats? We gave you treats already. Okay. Merrily We Roll Along. Before we take a sip, you know we have to recite the happy hour oath. Life is a waste of time. Time is a waste of life. So just get wasted all of the time and have the time of your life. Kungaloosh. Woohoo! That is absolutely yummy. It's better than Rocky Road ice cream, but it's liquid, it has a kick to it. You will love this. It's very, very deserty. The flavors with the almond and the Irish cream and the whipped cream all blend together well. And I'm telling you, it's better than Rocky Road. So, are we having any fun yet? Anybody having fun? All of you who checked in already, you raise your hands, are we having fun? Anybody else? I see, okay, good. Thank you for joining us. You know, I've mentioned this before. We are not condoning alcohol abuse or anything like that. We're just trying to have a little fun, make a couple of happy hour, Friday happy hour cocktails, and have fun doing it. And enjoy in moderation, as they say. All right, so let's go to our next drink, which will be on the town. Now this drink will also have half and half in it, and as I mentioned, you could use a substitute if you want to. This will be our liquid version of an after dinner mint. You know, those like those Andes chocolate mints, the chocolate covered and green mint on the inside. This will taste just like an Andes after dinner mint, only in liquid form, but it will pack a punch just like our first drink did. So we will start. All right, I know all of you know this who know me, but for the thousands who don't know me, I'm not a professional bartender. I'm not a mixologist.
You're a drinkologist.
I do have a certificate saying I'm an honorary drinkologist. So there you go. But it's something I enjoy doing. It's fun for me. And it's been so rewarding that so many of you have enjoyed what I've done and the concoctions that I've made. Let's start with... for this next drink, some creme de cacao. This is a chocolate flavored liqueur. This one is about 48 proof, so it's 24% alcohol. And it comes in dark and white. You could use either. We're using white just so we could end up with a green coloring like that. Okay, creme de cacao, chocolate liqueur. Now again, you could go high end, top of the shelf, and you know, use Godiva, but you don't have to spend that money to go that extra bit for an expensive brand. This is a perfectly good chocolate flavor, and save the Godiva for, as I mentioned before, when you're drinking it on its own or on the rocks, something in a purer form.
You've got more people here. You've got Mackenzie Perry's here.
Oh, thank you, Mackenzie.
Shelley Farabee is here.
Speaking of Mackenzie Perry, happy birthday to your sister, Caitlin. I hope you're with us. Okay, we're doing 2 ounces of the creme de cacao. And we will match that with 2 ounces of a creme de menthe. This is, of course, a mint-flavored liqueur. This is 30% alcohol, 60 proof. So we'll do 2 ounces of creme de menthe. And to give it that extra Fred drink kick, we're going to add some silver rum, light rum, silver rum, white rum. It's all the same. We mentioned before that refers to the color, not the alcohol content. So let's do two ounces. We'll match everything with this. This will give it that extra kick that. Punch it up a notch, and then we will go back to our half and half, and let's do 4 ounces of half and half, and you can do more. Again, you can adjust all of these if you want your drink to have more of a chocolatey or minty flavor, one or the other, adjust the amounts of those two liqueurs accordingly. And if you don't want it as strong, don't add the rum. Just use the two liqueurs. I don't know why you want to do that, but you have the option. Stirring again, not shaking. And let's fill another glass with ice. And this is on the town again. This we're calling on the town because. You will want to drink this after your dinner out on the town. It's a perfect after dinner cordial, and again, it has a chocolate mint after dinner mint taste, and it's also pretty. Okay, let's dress this one up. Excuse me, my throat gets a little dry doing this, so I have a I have a little a sip of rum standing by to loosen me up. I don't know where I'm going to go when the volcano blows, but where I go, I hope there's rum. Thank you, Jimmy Buffett, for that. Okay, we're now ready for our On the Town cocktail. And before we sip this, let us recite, and you, many of you probably know it by now, let's recite the happy hour motto. I love to drink martinis. Two at the very most. Three, and I'm under the table. Four, and I'm under the host. Conga loose. That is so good. Perfect, perfect after dinner cordial. The chocolate mint after dinner. Chocolate mint with a kick, of course, in liquid form. But you will enjoy this as well. Again, two cocktails using half and half, but very different drinks. They're a lot of fun. They are on the sweet side because they're desserty, but sometimes you need that as well. And what else do we have? Am I leaving out anything else? I mentioned before, well, I asked you, we want to wish a happy anniversary to our British friend, Jenny and James. Hard to believe that it was 11 years ago we were in New York with you for your wedding week. So we wish you all the best. Happy birthday again to our good friend, Judy and Caitlin. Now, if you're curious, if you want to know, I'm sure many of you have asked the question, am I wearing pants? Well, let me see. Well, I couldn't find my pants, but I found something else. I hope this will do. I don't know. That's okay, that's enough. It's enough silliness. Again, I mentioned we're not trying to promote any alcohol abuse. We're just trying to have a little fun, learn how to make a couple of cocktails with a little silliness infused. And I hope you've enjoyed it and had fun with us. So let's have another sip before we go. Until next time, conga loosh. Roll credits. Produced, directed by Aaron Thomas. Set decoration by Aaron Thomas. Co-directed, written, and hosted by Fab Freddie. Until next time, thank you.